the tribunal granted relief to them by directing their regularization, it should read in service, with effect from the date, which dates on which, I'm sorry for the typo.
In terms of 212, that would be 25 along 93.
In which they continued, they completed 5 years of service in terms of GOM dated 22-4, yes, but denied them monetary benefit. The order was confirmed in the first instance by the High Court, but upon review petition being filed, the order was modified to the extent that the appellants in the said case were held entitled to regularization of services only from the date on which they filed the OA. Faced with this situation, the Supreme Court observed that it found it difficult to accept the reasoning adopted by the High Court as to the right to seek regularization flowed from GOMs 212 dated 22-4-1994, and once the appellant rendered the requisite service in terms of the GOM dated 22-4-1994, but the authorities kept quiet without regularization of their services, they could not be denied relief. The Supreme Court held that the appellants were entitled to be regularized in service with effect from the date on which they completed 5 years continuous service, as was held in its earlier judgment in District Collector versus M.L. Singh. In the light of this pronouncement by the Supreme Court as recently as in August on the issue of regularization of service dated 22-4-1994, we have no hesitation in holding that the tribunal erred in denying relief to the petitioners and so far as they claim for regularization from anterior date was concerned. They would therefore be entitled to regularization of their services from the date they completed 5 years of service, but would not be entitled to any monetary benefits in terms of areas of pay. They would, however, be eligible for notional fixation.
25-11-93 was not considered.
No.
Not considered. Now your GO that you issued after the judgment talks of 25-11-93.
So,
they are happy with that. Where is the problem?
No, the problem is this, that they are granted regularization with effect on the basis that this is a continuous GO which applies for all times to come. Your Lordship say in Manjula, it doesn't. It's a one-time exercise. So what is done is, their services are regularized. But they say, give me seniority with effect from 1994, because as per the GO, 5 years, 1994 is the cutoff date.
93.
Yes. I'm only aggrieved by that part of the order. The part of the order which says, because this is not in respect of...
You are aggrieved by, now please specify, you are aggrieved by what part of the order?
The retrospective part of the order which regularizes their services with effect from 1993.
The GO
as interpreted in Manjula says, A, it's a one-time measure.
The teeth of that GO, Mr. MD, you take out another...
One-time measure, all employees who had completed 5 years as on 25, they will be given benefit. That's the one-time measure.
Then what is the... We don't understand.
So the GO that we are concerned in this case, Manoj, is categorically says it will apply only from a prospective date. Just see page 30.
Item 13 now, right? 13. Page 30,
Manoj.
Yes.
There's
year from number 21. Subsequent. Yes.
So far as they are concerned, in the circumstances, later known so and so, careful examination hereby accord to the commissioner to regularize the services of 306 annexed to the order in terms of the orders issued in GO first from prospective date. That is the date of issue of the orders by the competent authority subject to the condition.
That you can't do. That you can't do. How can you deny them?
So they have,
once you are regularizing them only on the ground that they completed 5 years on 25-11-93, how you can postpone the effect thereof?
They have not completed.
King.
They have not completed 5 years on 25-11.
Then if not, then they are not entitled to be regularized. It's not your case.
So, Manoj, my respectful submission is that this...
Even the High Court's order is very clear.
That the Lordship's view in Manjula was not that, Manoj, this applies across the board to all employees. It's a one-time measure, Manoj, where there is a particular cutoff date prescribed. It is not something that you will apply in perpetuity, because otherwise the judgment in Manjula, Manoj, has no meaning. And all those persons were declined relief. And then you had Section 7 of the Act, Manoj, which Manjula notices. This will be in the teeth of the Act, Manoj, because the idea of the Act is that a person Maloj who gets in through the back door, who's not appointed through regular channels, will not really Maloj get regularization over those who come through an employment exchange and through proper channels. And it nullifies Maloj condition 5 of the GO, which says you can only appoint against a substantive vacancy. Now, if there is no vacancy, Maloj, where is the question of regularization before that date? Maloj, that turns service jurisprudence on its head. That even without vacancies, grant them regularization.
That's not the case. Your own GO says that it has to be, if the vacancies are there.
There are,
you have to pass an order that there is no vacancy. That's why we can't.
There are no vacancies.
So, there are no vacancies, Maloj.
Then make your own, pass it.
Pass your own order.
Why are you in appeal?
Why are you in appeal then?
We don't understand that. Why should you come here? Go by your GO.
That is because, Maloj, the operative direction, Maloj, in the impugned order. Maloj categorically say.
No, please come back. Come to the operative. Again, let's go back to the operative.
So, Lashi, permit me one paragraph. One paragraph.
No, you will. Let him finish, please. Not before. Sorry, sir. Let him finish.
I'm grateful. Yes.
Page 8. Once the parent renders the requisite service in terms of GOM 22494, they could not give you relief. The Supreme Court held that the parents were entitled to be regularized in service irrespective of the date they completed 5 years, as was laid down in MLC.
MLC is distinguished, is clarified in Manjula. Kindly see MLC.
GO 2125 itself talks of 25.11.93.
And subsequent one also talks about 25.11.83.
And your own resolution granting permission for regularization talks of 25.11.83. How can you believe that it's not a one-time measure?
You yourself are saying, though we are doing all this, this is contrary to one judgment of the Supreme Court, but now you clarify the judgment.
With the greatest respectful submission, the judgment in Manjula, Maloj, very clearly says, A, it's a one-time measure. Second, Maloj, the judgment in Manjula, with the greatest respect. Just see paragraph 59. M.L. Singh is specifically noted. Your lady.
Right, Mr. MD, we've heard you. We are not convinced. Take down. We've heard Learned Counsel for the petitioners. We are giving the privilege of this arguments to the other state also. You want to argue it all over? You argue it, we'll pass a comment. Go ahead.
May I have your lordship, please?
Thank you. Thank you for your assistance. Mm-hmm.
Please, my lord, without taking my loss to GO.
This is Andhra, right?
Yes, my lord, may have.
19.
That's yes. The compilation. With
yes.
Status are in 13 as well. Mine is. Pertains to Andhra, but it's in 13.5. So,
my lord, the note that 13.5 should go with 19. Andhra, 13.5 should go with 19.
There are also certain municipalities who are in state and authorities who have their own methodologies of.
Okay, but we are directing 13.5 to go with Andhra batch. It's erroneously in 13. Yes. Point out, please. It's a wrongly placed in your category of Telangana. It should go to Andhra. There's no issue. Just indicate those numbers so that we put it. Let's see if you have to pass a separate order at all.
Ashu, permit me, lad. Only one word about Manjula Bashti. They lads you, sir. Para 102, my lad.
Para 102.
The cutoff date was 93, but the division bench shifted the date to 1988. Their lashes found fault with that, and the rest of it they have confirmed. that para 102 and 103, they will clarify.
Shifting of the date is what is being interfered.
The complaint was started to be shifted. They last shifted to the one contained
yes.
at the...
Para 101.
Yes, yes.
Two submissions, not for my
election. For whom? You are for the employees? Yes.
19.3 also. I am appearing
for 19.3. So you are arguing contrary to this concept of 25.11.93.
What do you want to say?
What is your argument?
I was just pointing out what Lamit Sanger argued regarding.
But you heard us. You are not convinced. What do you want to point out? Unless we are convinced, then it's a different matter. We'll issue, we'll direct that it may be granted. We are still at the leave stage. Yes.
I will not take my lords to GOMS 212 again. However, I request my lords to bear in mind this concept, this prerequisite of a vacancy. And I'll tell my lords why it becomes important. My lords, yeah, there may have been, my lords, may
no interruption now.
Leave with your lordship.
Please. Your colleague is here.
My lords, the regularization has to be a vacancy.
Before you go on to that submission, please tell us any document or any communication indicating that they were working against non-existent posts. Please tell us.
My lords, on record, there is no such thing. However,
then chapter close, you can't argue that.
My lords, may kindly consider. Suppose a vacancy.
Another question. Just as state of Telangana has taken out this GO subsequently, have you also done this?
My lords, not indicated by the material on record. However, my lords, I can't seek instructions. I can't make the statement like
no, this. No, we'll have to, whatever you have to say now. We are just clarifying. Because if you've done it and it's not on record, respondents? Anybody for the respondents in the Andhra case?
My lords, it may be.
Should GO subsequent to the judgment saying comply?
Subject to
SP.
That's okay. Subject. They made a right. They added a right.
Yeah,
like, unlike Telangana.
I'm aware of. I thought if a parimateria GOMS was an issue. Therefore, my lords, when I talk of, and I am talking of this requirement of a sanctioned vacancy again and again, my lords, because factually the situation which has arisen is, suppose a person is working casually from 82, 88. And on 93, admittedly, he completes 5 years. But on that day, there exists no vacancy. He is thereafter regularized against a vacancy, which comes up in 98. In that case, can he get the notional pensionary benefit of the 93 GO? That is my primary grievance. All of these persons have been regularized.
All right, let us see from your pleadings before the High Court that this argument was made. Let's see your pleadings, please. Yes, 19, yes, item number 19. Yes, all right, read your reply in the High Court, please. This argument
is the counter for submission. Record. The counter is not on record.
And argument advance on your behalf before the High Court, yes.
High Court doesn't accept this and goes on a slightly...
What is this affidavit you filed at Annexure P7? Is that by any chance?
P7?
Yes.
Come to the affidavit.
That is a reply affidavit.
Yes.
Yes, let's see. That there were no vacancies, non-existent vacancies. Let us see.
Yes, 186.
Paragraph 16.
16.
Paragraph 15.
Yes.
The Honorable Tribunal failed to appreciate the fact that once the respondents have accepted their regularization.
This is not your argument.
No, my lord, subsequently. My lord, may just regularization, which was issued in the year 2000.
Yes.
We are stopped from challenging the same. 16. The Honorable Tribunal failed to appreciate the fact that as per GO212 also, there should be a clear vacancy and the GO260 dated 8-10-2009.
Vacancies of which year?
No clear vacancy.
vacancies of which year, madam?
2009.
You have to come out with a clear case. 1993. This was the number of vacancies.
Cut-off date.
Yes. This was the number of vacancies. This is the number of employees.
As on
date statement.
When they
did the dark.
We'll have to say on this date when they were in that there were no vacancies.
This was the number of this was the number of employees.
Where is that? A very general statement.
But no, my lord, this adverts to the fact that when a vacancy arose in 2009, they were regularized. However, my lord, I'm mindful of what my lord is saying. I'm not shying.
Don't there be any material on record. We'll not let you argue. It was arguments for the first time in this court. Yes.
GOMS 212 provides positive directions, positive conditions for the conferment of regularization. The one positive direction, positive condition being the existence of a clear vacancy.
Have you come out with a vacancy status?
That's why we
have the vacancy status.
First, that there is a clear vacancy or there is no vacancy.
No vacancy. Any statement to that?
However, my lords, I will, one more.
No. We can't ask you, permit you to improve your case because you can't go beyond your averments in your counter. So in para 16, you are as vague as you can be. That's what you're saying. That's why there should be clear vacancy. And you're saying as on 8, 10, 9, there is no clear vacancy.
My lords, may kindly consider that today here, we are only, the issue which arises for my lord's consideration is only the benefits and the date from the pensionary benefits and the date from which they would be reckoned. My lords, in that regard, kindly have my compilation. We issued a GOM in 97, my lords, which continues to hold the field, which Srinivasalu and ML Singh have not taken note of, which clearly states that the benefits would be prospective. My lords, may kindly have page 40 of my compilation.
Page
40 of my compilation, 40, my lord.
Written submissions.
Yes, my lord. My written submissions.
There's no page 40.
Hey, copy of GO dated 1997. PDF 525. One. This is serial number 6 of that bookmark.
Yes.
My lord,
97.
Yes, please.
It is hereby clarified that on the basis of Act 2 of 93, government had issued GOMS 212 finance prescribing conditions for regularization of services of irregularly appointed people. After the issue of the GO, as clearly mentioned in paragraph 2 of this order, all earlier orders on regularization stand annulled. Therefore, any specific GO for any category, including work charged employees issued by any department in the government, stands superseded from 22494 in view of the scheme formulated. Para 2, the regularizations that are done as per GOMS 212 dated 24494 is given the benefit of regularized service to the person concerned only from the date of the issue of the order making it prospective. Therefore, my lords, this concept of going back,
it's notional benefits which have been given, not actual benefits.
That the court has kept in mind, please.
Yes.
So that the exchange.
And in this, you also don't indicate that there are no vacancies available.
Should not be a consideration at all, but the burden on the exchequer, even with these notional benefits, is 8,800 crores. However, that is not a point for the consideration of this.
So you have been extracting services from these employees all those years. Had they been regularly appointed employees, what would have been the burden? Please tell us.
Much higher than at least what they are getting.
My lords, may kindly consider how, and my lords would say, you keep coming back to Uma Devi. But Uma Devi 3 deals with specifically this situation.
You violated to the hilt.
You yourself
can't ask to indulge you because you violated Uma Devi.
Besides,
my lords, may kindly consider.
So we can't be indulging violating.
Uma Devi is 85.
Uma Devi 3, my lords.
Yes.
Six.
So these by then much order at home because your GOs are of 94.
Lords,
yes.
many of them are subsequent. And Uma Devi and other judgments of my lords have also taken
through. You having violated the judgments of the Supreme Court, want indulgence from us to say that no, okay, interpret it in this way because we issued a GO, but we violated it. Now, the another GO, we violated it. But you interpreted it in such a way that it should not be treated as from 1983, it should be done prospective. Can't be.
My lords may kindly consider.
We have heard learned counsel for both the matters. We have heard learned counsel for the parties.
One clarification, my lord.
In which matter?
In item 13, there are some matters in which there was no GO, but they got regularization basis the orders of the court or the tribunal.
But the
GO means? GO was a general GO.
Thereafter, there are specific GOs regularizing the services.
They are all employees, just one. All employees who had completed 5 years by then, all right. That's sufficient.
That's okay. Couldn't make it. Then we have heard learned. We have heard learned counsel for the petitioners at some length. Counsel for the petitioners at some length. We have also heard arguments addressed on behalf of the respondents, having perused the improved judgment, as also the relevant GOs, namely GO number, give us those numbers, please, so that there's no scope of any misinterpretation another time. GO MS number 212, dated 22/4/1994. Tell us, give us the GO numbers.
212.1
in the state of Telangana. Give us the number date, so we are having to shift files back and forth. Give the number.
Give it on a slip, please.
No error. There are two GOs or three?
Two GOs.
No. Telangana, two. Andhra.
When you take down, madam.
Please be careful in noting in the case. GO number 212, dated 22/4/1994. Because this is state of AP and that is a unified state at that time. So whatever applied to AP would apply in Telangana. Yes. Right? And the other GO dated? Number? 533 dated 29/11/2011, and then again one after the judgment.
This is the corporation which was identified.
They are giving the GO numbers. Please tell us the date of the GO after the judgment.
19/3/2018.
Compliance GO. No, we have not discussed any beyond that. Please, you keep it. Yes.
In compliance.
Which is the other one? Last one. Off. Dated.
2018. Same date.
Put it on a list so that there's no error. Put it on a piece of paper clearly and give it to the CM. There's no error. Now, and are of the opinion. Please don't interject. And are of the opinion, and have also perused the judgment cited before us, including the judgment in the case of A. Manjula, Ashini and others, versus Managing Director, Andhra Pradesh Women Cooperative Finance Corporation Limited, at the foot 2009-8-SCC-431, comma, then say another one. ML Singh is District Collector versus Chairman versus ML Singh 2009-8-SCC-480 and B. Srinivas Bulbu, is it got a citation?
2021-13-SCC-460.
And lastly, one more, this one which has been quoted. And lastly, order dated 12/7/2024, passed in SLP number 1, diary number 1354024, Government of Andhra Pradesh, bracket now Government of Telangana and others, versus G. Jagannatham and others. Right? And of the firm view that the no interference is called for in the impugned judgments dated, so mention both the judgments, one impugned in 13 and the other impugned in 19. Tribune judgment dated 1st said so-and-so passed by the High Court for the state of Telangana at Hyderabad, and impugned judgment dated so-and-so passed by in the other matter, right? Separated. Especially petitions are accordingly dismissed along with the pending application.
It is not to say anything now. Just a clarification, my lords. My lords, suppose somebody is in service since 83. They complete 5 years on 88. However, it is my humble submission that the benefits ought to be extended from the cutoff date, not from completing 5 years in service. At least that may be borne in mind, my lords.
What have you said in your GO?
My lords, GO 212, my lords.
From the date of completion of
5 years.
My lord, that is not, the GO does not talk of the benefits, which is why they issued a clarification.
Once the regularization is effected, the benefits will follow automatically.
In my humble submission, the regularization was effected in 93.
I think we should now, that's it. We don't want to be on.
Give a closure to this.
That is all. Time for you to implement. 1 minute. Separately, we have also perused the judgment stated so-and-so, and are of the opinion that the view taken in the impugned judgments is in line with the view expressed by this court in A. Manjula Bhashini and others. We are of the opinion that contrary to the submission made by Learned Counsel for the petitioners, the impugned judgment is in line with the decision of this court court in A. Manjula Bhashini and others.
My lords, there are GOMS would now amount to 200 to 250. My lords, may clarify just the GOMS issued in pursuance of 212. Otherwise, it will become very difficult to collate from all the corporations, all the municipalities, and get.
No. We are referring only to GOMS number 212. Mentioned 212 dated.
Act also.
You have an act.
Act also, yes.
To mentioning an act also. GOMS number 212 dated 22/4/1994. Then what is the act?
My lord, we'll write it in.
1 minute. Where is your act?
And my lord says something else. 212 carved out an exception to the act. Like my lord saw, the act bars regularization of service.
There. That may not be necessary.
No.
Okay, GO number so and so, and the GOMS and the GOs issued subsequent thereto for purpose of regularization, as also we will need to refer to Telangana's GO, that we need to refer to, because that has come subsequent to the impugned judgment. Right? Who's preparing for Telangana? For the subsequent judgment, we have to mention that, because subsequent to the judgment, you have issued two GOs. Those two GOs, your colleague has mentioned. So we will also have to mention those two. In the case of Andhra, there are now...
Those would not be in my humble submission.
Then say, and the GOs issued subsequent to the impugned judgments. That should cover it. And the GOs issued subsequent to the impugned judgments. That should give a closure to the car. That should cover it widely now. Fine enough. Yes.
Compliance till a time.
How much we will give? All right. Let us hear them on this.
My lords, I will seek instructions, but we will need a longer
period. Now that the impugned judgments have been upheld and the present petitions have been dismissed, the petitioner state government are directed to implement the impugned judgment judgments within
9 months, my lords. My lords.
What are you saying?
In Andhra alone, my lords, we have it for that long, Mr. Morgan.
No need. Say that by 31st of December 2024. At least they should have a timeline. They should have not at least. We are very sure that when if we would give you March, you would come in a March and tell us give us September. If we would give you September, you would come and say give us March. So now we are giving you December for you to assumably open a window. To come to us in December and say, give us March, we'll consider it then.
Budgetary allocations are made for each year. My lords, may give us a long.
We are saying till December 31st. That's good enough. Thank you. Here are the judgments. 33 tagged with this. 33 is Andhra. That's also tagged with this. Thank you. wherever substitution is pending, allow it.
Lashup, this is the common judgment for all the batch matters.
Yes.
We are not taking out, we are not taking
any exceptions.
Across the board.
We are dismissed the appeals chapter 12.
Yes, 14, please. Thank you. We had to put your back against the wall. It would never have happened otherwise.
We are very sorry for taking time and inconvenience.
It's okay. You can't help it. You have instructions to follow.
Files. We could just look.
That's all right. That's fine. We don't blame you for it. You did your best. Yes. Yes,
we must appreciate that.
Yes.
14.49, different matter, Milad. That is.
What is? How is it different?
The non-relieving of periodical increments. That OIA is filed. OIA is allowed. Tribunal, High Court confirmed. This honorable court also.
You want us to keep it aside? 19.449. All right, we will detach it.
Detached.
You want to detach it? Why are you mentioning it? Yes. Yes. Pass over 14. Mr. Perry. Yes, please. Of course. Yes. Tell us.
Four employees who work only for 1 year, one academic year, 95-96. And that too, my lord, the manner of working, etc., is a serious, my lord, question. My lord, directly.
All that you would have been able to demonstrate had you conducted a proper inquiry.
No, my lord, no, that is not the issue.
What is the issue?
Please have a look at page 33.
First, make your point.
Yeah, point out. What has happened is, in this school, but there are four or five issues that I'm raising. But in this school, will not be.
Sorry, just for an idea, how much time would you take in this matter?
I will take about maybe 35 minutes.
You wouldn't be able to. There's nothing in the matter for you to take. Maybe 3 to 5 minutes. We'll hear you. Go ahead.
May I just point out what the issue is? Or what the issues are?
Yes.
March 1995, there was election in the managing committee and Milord, first choice group was Milord, ousted. However, Milord, they tried to still keep control over the management. As a result of that, Milord, the present controversy has arisen.
Yes.
Appointment orders, Milord, which are issued in favor of these four employees. Milord, page 33 is one such appointment order. It categorically says it is temporary for that academic year. That is, Milord, 95-96. It is also, Milord, an admitted fact that the concerned employees are worked only for that academic year, 95-96.
Yes.
The management, Milord, which was supporting the group, not management, the group which was supporting the employees, Milord, put in a one-page written statement that we are supporting the claim for the tribunal. We went to the High Court, etc. In the meanwhile, the proceedings under the Bombay Public Trust Act, for Milord submitting change report and Milord getting ultimately order, were going on. Those proceedings came to be concluded ultimately where Milord, it was held that yes, we are the actual management committee and our file management committee has lost Milord the claim that they are in the
list. March 2009.
It came in March 2009. But surprisingly, in the pending writ petition, the employees come and say, not you, he is the president. So, Milord, even in 2009, Milord, even after the judgment, Milord, they claim that no, not you, they are the manager. That's, Milord, how it goes. A person, Milord, and Milord, of the four employees, advertisement was published in May. And you know, two employees are given as per the High Court judgment are up and doing prior to that. That you know, High Court has prepared a chart. So you know, even about that, you know, it is something you know, it creates a lot of suspicions. Even for the academic year in which they work, no salary actually was discussed that because that you know, management had no control over them, control over the actual running of the school. As a result of that, they worked only for academic year. And you know, the education officer, the concerned you know, Jilla Parishad authority, who is competent to examine you know, and sanctioned the appointment only for one academic year. That also is not in dispute. That is part of the record. So well, this is the background in which the order of reinstatement with full back wages is granted by the High Court or confirmed by the High Court. In the meanwhile, my lord, that is something, my lord, that is happening all over, at least in Maharashtra. The schools which are running Marathi medium schools are going down and down in terms of registration of numbers. I have brought on record, my lord, the latest, the actual sanction strength.
How does it look, Jeremy?
You are only a Shiksha Sansthan. You have to confine yourself to the society.
Even in my school, the student strength and the sanction strength of the teachers and the employees has come down. That, my lord, I have brought on record. This is another issue, my lord, which needs to be considered in the light of
what these matters. How is that relevant?
To the impugned order.
Sorry?
We'll be able to only confine ourselves to the impugned order, not the larger picture.
No, my lord, that is something, my lord, I will point out why. I will point out why. But before that, my lord, this is something that, my lord, needs to be considered because the whole claim of my lord, the four employees, two teachers and my lord, two fools, is based on that you are not the management. I will show that, my lord, their affidavit filed before the High Court. Lord, first of all, Lord, please have a look at page 33.
We are not going into whether you are the management or not. We are going into the correct
legality of the orders.
Today that issue is concluded. Lord, fortunately, that issue is not something which is uncertain now. Bad judgment.
Now, the issue here is come to para 10 of the impugned order.
Please, my lord.
Starting at if you want to start
story
at
or history, is irrelevant for this purpose.
Please bear with me. I need to show some documents on record before yours. Please have a look at page 33 first.
Yes, 33.
Appointment order.
Yes, appointment order.
Yes.
Lord, this is my lord the starting point. Even according to my lord the respondents, my lord.
Yes.
Dated 12/6/1990.
We are going by that your appointment is for 1 year.
Temporary.
Yes.
And
this is such an interesting thing. Who is it?
Para 2 is relevant.
Yes, we marked it. Your appointment is solely temporary.
Solely temporary for a period of 1 year, months, year from. Lord, it should be 95. It's a typo. 12/6/1995 34/1996. Just one academic year, June to April. In the deputation vacancy, after expiry of the above period, your services will stand terminated without any notice.
Next line is very important. Yes.
Your appointment is subject to the
approval.
Yes.
Final subject to approval and then on probation for a period of 2 years. So this is contrary to what is recorded in
probation is 2 years, yes. Appointment is subject to 2 years.
I just point out what happens is there is a format prescribed. When below the temporary period dates are given, it's that below which applies or probation below doesn't apply.
So how is it written here, your appointment on probation?
Well, therefore, the dates are given here.
It may be, but this is also part of the order, your appointment.
Please have to get or. But or is the that's because of the format.
Where is the
or approval?
Or,
no, this is some.
Not your appointment. Right. Your appointment will be subject to final.
This is this is a typo. It can't be.
When a photocopy of the application is not on record, which is a system followed in this court, that the true typed version will be there. But if it's a format, we are not able to have the benefit of the format.
May I just point out the format which is prescribed under the Act? It says temporary for so and so period or for probation. That's how it is. And therefore, the schools will not continue to not be the same format. And that's how. And this is the appointment order issued by the so-called person got in the under the control of that erstwhile group. It's not my appointment. Later on, they realized that they issued my lord appointment on probation. That is separate. Page 37.
Yes.
And then, my lord, they change it to, my lord, 38, your appointment is probation. Where, my lord, in the earlier clause, no dates are filled in. But, my lord, that is subsequent. Like that, that's what they say, my lord, before the High Court. I will point out that that's not the point.
So tell us what is
the application officer, my lord, ultimately approves the appointment only for one academy.
Yes, that is yes.
Lord, page
one. Once the education officer comes into picture, then the ratification of the appointment is there. You can't say that it is fabricated. Yes. Well, where is the question?
Yes, 45. Yes. Where at 45?
Yes, my lord. At the bottom.
Yes.
Name of the candidate, etc. is at the top. And my lord, a remark, see so-and-so pune in respect of his appointment for the reason that he has worked in 95-96 only up to so-and-so. His appointment is approved. If any dispute in respect of his appointment, then salary expenses of the same shall be recovered from the granting aid. So, my lord, for each of them, academic year, the appointment is approved. And they have not worked beyond that at any point of time till date. Not all those four, my lord, I got three are there. My lord, this is one thing. Lord, please have a look at now affidavit which is filed before the High Court. Before that,
today they are. What is their status today?
They are not working.
You?
They have removed us, my lord. They have not.
You?
Removed means they don't continue.
They don't continue you because.
Who there is no question.
We are looking at the.
Point out. Even in my reply to my petition, I have specifically stated that employees have to aver that they are not, my lord, gainfully employed.
You have not averred?
They have not stated.
That's why we are asking you. Did you make any averment anywhere that you are not gainfully employed?
What happens is this. But as soon as, my lord, we were orally terminated, we have filed
an. So, question of termination. Your tenure was for 1 year.
Orally
it was a tenure based appointment. Where is the continuation? Yes.
Your lordship, see, before that, may I just point from some more things? So that
no, first we want to understand why is he saying it's an apart termination?
No, not because they orally terminated.
What happens is termination.
I'll tell you.
Did you complete that 1 year?
I completed that.
Then when's the question of oral
termination? I completed that period. Let me complete, you know, what has happened. You know, 1995, an advertisement was issued. You know, we were appointed by following due procedure, regular appointment.
What was the procedure? Tell us.
Advertisement was issued.
The procedure, please.
That's what I'm saying.
What was the procedure we were asking you? Where is the advertisement? All right, let's see. Let's see.
Come to an extra B1.
Yes.
32?
Yes.
10595.
What is the criterion in the adjustment? Time basis. So it was never an adjustment for the purpose of a regular selection.
Termination.
No termination.
This is what they have annexed. Now, my lord, please see page 35.
Have you annexed something different from this?
I have not annexed.
But must be the same.
Now, my lord, please see page 35.
Yes.
35 onwards. Now, page 35 is the resolution by the erstwhile. You know, what happens is this. There is a dispute.
Ms. Counsel, what done if it is to the adjustment? There is no question. Do you have any leave in the post? Yes.
Fight amongst each other. We were appointed by following due procedure on probation. Now the
No question of probation.
It was a simple contractual appointment. Your letter of appointment is clear. You can't go beyond it.
For a moment.
We are seeing way 35.
Now this is a resolution passed by the erstwhile managing.
Yes.
7th of May 1995.
Yes.
Now this is, you know, there are two assistant teachers and two peons. There are four people who are before your lordship, two assistant teachers and two peons. Now please see page 35.
Yes, we have it.
Srimati Mangal Ramchandra Patil, on the condition of attaining grant to the standard 5th division 4, the following teacher is appointed on probation subject to approval of the education officer on DH so and so. Now, my lord, please see, this is page 37. At page 38, my lord. Though it mentions temporary, but please see page 38. Your appointment is on a probation for a period of 3 years. Now, my lord, please see the next page. Page 40.
No, you're reading out of context. Para 2. Your appointment is purely temporary.
There's two things which are mentioned in the appointment order.
Sir, expiry, your services will be terminated without notice.
Right. The courts will not permit me to show that. The observations will not permit me to show.
Right, we are granting leave. Of the tribunal. We are granting leave. Why is the mic not working? Doesn't seem to be working.
Even from here,
yes, the mic isn't working. Anyway, leave grant. Listen to your post. I know, that is already a stage. Yes, the court is. Again, I don't know, still the mic is not working. It's 4:45. We don't propose to take any further matters for the day. The courtmaster will give the dates and the other matters, please. Yes, Mr.
2 p.m. Yes, but
item number was
30.
That one really
30.1. 30 and 30.1.
For the respondent hospital.
It's a regular matter. Excuse me. Nandkishan, item 30, kal lag sakta hai, it's a appeal. Parso lag sakta hai. All right, we'll go to day after.
I have some difficulty tomorrow and day after. Give me tomorrow, my lord. I'm ready.
I'm not there.
Day after. You're not here.
I'm not here tomorrow.
Week after, Wednesday.
Yes. Week after would be.
A week after, Wednesday. Yeah, hi. Then you can put it higher.
31st.
Yes, thank you. Mention.
Okay. The book is, in fact, last week it was. I'm deeply grateful.
1 minute from here, the mentioning starts. You go ahead. You go ahead. The other mentioning is continuing. Yes. Any mentioning here? Yes. Yes, please, madam. Well, yes. What about it? What about it?
My husband to deposit 25 lakh
milots
within 2 weeks.
Who's preparing on the other
side? Not appearing before the trial court milots, executing court milots. Kindly call him by NBW milots.
She's feeling so funny. She's the wife. She's preparing for the wife. Okay. See, we had said on 30th April without prejudice, he's directed to deposit 25. So he's not deposited the amount.
Lordship, I appear for the respondent, Lord.
I have informed. One minute. You are preparing for the husband, right?
Yes.
Yes. What is the status?
I informed him about the last order, Lordship. Later on, I came to know he has been hospitalized. He was admitted in hospital.
Then,
recently, I am not able to contact him.
Lord, he is avoiding.
The referring council has informed me and informed me that he requires some means he could not deposit the entire amount.
For which he has not moved any application on 30th of April. He was directed to deposit it within 2 weeks from 30th of April. That ended before the court vacations. And even after the vacations, virtually end of the month, this is what you have to say?
He was hospitalized.
Yes, summoning him there. Let him appear before the court. Take down in item 35 and point 1, when it comes for the petitioner wife. Sorry, petitioner's wife in 23849 of 23. Submits that the respondent husband has not complied with the order passed on 30th of April 2024, on which date it was directed that without prejudice to his rights, he may deposit a sum of rupees 25 lakhs in terms of the impound order within 2 weeks from the date of passing of the said order. It is stated by learned counsel for the respondent, for the wife, that the husband is deliberately evading the court process and has not made compliances. That a counsel for the husband submits that he had duly conveyed the order passed on 30th of April 2024 to his client, and
And thereafter, it has been informed that he has been hospitalized.
And when was this now? Recently?
No, recently I could not contact him. I contacted referring.
In April or May? When did you contact him?
In my May, Lord. In May or June.
And in May 2024, in the month of May 2024, the Senate Council was informed that that the husband had been hospitalized. Thereafter, he has not heard from his client at all. So that issue, bailable warrants to secure the presence of the respondent husband for the next date of hearing, list on the date of the actual date. Any other mentioning?
This is a appointment matter, my lord.
23.
I am very much anxious to get it disposed of, reason being it's a compassionate appointment matter, my lord.
23, give a shorter date, it's a compassionate. Tomorrow is a Wednesday. You tend to forget how the board functions in this court.
Can it be kindly be at the top of the board, my lord?
Can it be on tomorrow? It's a regular day. Do you realize it? Put it on. This is respondent. That's okay. We will accommodate you since it's a compassionate appointment matter.
99 man is struggling alone.
All right. We will put it on a shorter
date. He died at the age of 40. He's reached to the age of 40.
Please put it on a shorter date. This item number 20. Okay.
Item,
yes.
Item 40, Mr. Diwan had also mentioned. But the man is out of job from 2019. Not only 4 years of service are left. Your lordship will accommodate some.
We had indicated the vintage of your matter also to Mr. Diwan. Do you remember? The court master will accommodate. Anything else? Anything else, anybody?
Lordship,
what is wrong with the system? My throat has gone hoarse today.
Lordship, item 22. It might be a matter of small constitutional significance, so we would request your lordship.
Item
22. There's a minor constitutional significance in that.
It's okay.
Shorter date.
Item 48 for a person with disability, your ladyship would ask me to check it.
Ladyship, an item.
Yes. Which matter? Yes. Yes. 22 and 22.2. This is a batch of up to 0.4. Yes. Who's on the... Give a date which is shorter if it is a pension.
Your ladyship...
Let's see.
Your ladyship, item 48 indicated to come at the end of the
month. Master, see what you can do.